What are you doing here?
Should be sharing your cell, Stephen's governor's orders. I'll take that bed on your right. Okay?
What happened to the things in my locker?
Oh, Mrs. Morris took them.
Hello, Parker. You ready for dinner? Well, the rest of the ladies are gone down.
Oh, Colleen, the police are in reception. They're asking for you.
For me? My God. She must have found them.
Come on, Parker. I'm not going to hurt you. Hey?
No, you stay away from me.
Cass. Now, Cass, it's all right. Come on, love. Settle down. Settle down. I'll see that she gets to the dining room, okay?
Look, I'm sorry. I thought I could show she had nothing to be afraid of. Parker, I'm sorry.
Yes. He didn't mean to frighten you.
Yeah. You'll stay with me, but won't you, Mick?
Don't worry, dear, I will. Yeah. Now, let's go and get our tea.
Yeah.
Come on. Come on.
Hello, Inspector. Stay, please, Mick.
Sorry to trouble you at this time of the day, Mrs. Powell, but we've had information that one of your officers might be able to help us in our inquiries into a hit-and-run.
What have you been told?
Well, a witness said that he saw a woman in what looked like a prison officer's uniform near where the victim was found.
I'm glad you're here, Inspector. I was just about to come and see you myself.
About the accident?
Yes. I was driving the car that hit that man.
Yes, yes. All right, I'll tell her first thing in the morning. Thank you.
Oh, off today.
Yep.
Oh, half your luck. What are the police doing here? They didn't even ask to speak to the governor, just wanted to see Mrs. Powell.
There now. Maybe I better stick around for a while, just in case I'm needed.
Hello, Mr. Manning. Getting a hang of the place?
I still need a map to find my way around. Other than that, no worries. Apart from Parker.
What about Parker?
I don't think it's anything serious. She just gets scared stupid every time she claps eyes on me.
Wouldn't take that too lightly. She decapitated our last male officer.
Yeah, so I heard. But from what I understand, it was a clear case of self-defence.
Oh, that's her story. If you ask me, we'd all be a lot safer if she were put away in an asylum for the criminally insane.
I'm sure you know these ladies better than I do, Miss Ferguson, but don't you think that's a bit heavy? I mean, what Parker's been through, she's bound to be shaky for a while.
These women don't need sympathy, Mr. Manning. But no doubt you'll find that out in time. The hard way.
Well, that's all I can tell you, Inspector. Except to say that I had no reason to believe that he was hurt.
Well, thank you for being so honest, Mrs. Powell. Now, if we can just find a witness to corroborate what you've told us.
Yes, there is a witness.
The prison officer we've been told about.
The whole incident was seen by our acting deputy governor, Joan Ferguson. Meg, would you see if she's still here, please?
Yes, of course.
Hello, Belinda.
What do you want?
I know you had it fixed to be put in with Sonia, and I have a pretty good idea why.
Maybe you.
Belinda, don't you realize that if anything happens to Sonia after lockup, there is no way you'll get away with it?
Isn't right. I'm getting pretty sick of telling you. Just rack off or start making life really unpleasant. Are you going to move, or am I?
Okay. But you should think about what I've said to you. Hurting Sonia is not worth spending the rest of your life in this dump for.
How shall we dance?
I'm choosy with my partners.
Well, that's not what I read on the dunny walls.
I hear you're top dog now.
So?
So perhaps you tried to get rid of the competition by stabbing me in the back.
Oh, God.
Literally.
Sorry, Inspector. There's nothing more I can tell you.
You didn't see Mrs. Powell at all?
No.
Well, then why would Mrs. Powell call on you to corroborate her account of the accident?
Well, she must have misunderstood me. I didn't see the accident at all. When I arrived at the scene, the man was already dead.
Why didn't you stay and talk to the police?
Oh, I didn't think it was necessary. There was a man there already with the body when I arrived, and there didn't seem to be any more that I could do to help.
Yeah. Right. Well then, Mrs. Powell, we'll have to ask you to accompany us to the station. We'll need a formal statement.
All right. Sorry I wasted your time, Miss Ferguson.
That's all right, Mrs. Powell. Just wish I could have been of more help.
Bobby, it's your turn.
Bloody cards. I wish they'd bring the telly back. It's boring with nothing to do.
Yeah, I miss the cartoons.
Mm. Where's your Superman comic, dear?
I don't know. I suppose Phyllis must still be reading it.
Yeah, that'd be right. It'd take her that long.
Yeah.
Dear, I noticed Belinda didn't take too kindly to your suggestion.
That's an understatement. From what you told me, you don't know why you bothered. Sonia had been no loss.
She killed Sonia. She'd be inside for years.
So what? Her life's not worth much anyway, being blind.
No, I wouldn't like being blind.
Me neither.
For heaven's sake, listen to the two of you. You'd think it was the end of the world because you lose one of your faculties.
Yeah, I reckon you might be right there, Min. There's a few around here without a brain. They don't seem to worry.
No, dear, that's why you're getting on so well.
Anyway, you're missing the point, love. If there's any more trouble around here, we're going to be the ones that suffer.
You're suffering already.
Any ideas how to stop it, though, Judy?
Not really, unless we put a tail on her. At least we're following her constantly. She can't get up to any more trouble. I'm out.
It should be easy. I mean, we could all take turns.
Well, I'll be in that, Jude. Anything beats sitting around here all day.
Oh, but you've got to finish the game first. Wouldn't be fair to stop now. Min's got four kings.
Yes, you're not supposed to tell people what you've got.
Oh, my God.
Hey, hang on a minute. Belinda's leaving. Do you want me to follow her?
No. You let her get a bit of a head start, and then you stay well behind. Don't get seen or you'll blow it, okay?
Okay.
Thanks, Mrs. Powell.
Do I have to be here much longer?
Could be a while. We're checking out the possibility of another witness.
Someone who saw it all?
Well, you hope so. The fellow who stayed with the body said there was a young bloke there as well. Reckon he didn't want to be involved with the coppers.
Well, wouldn't have hurt him to make a statement.
Well, maybe it would. Could be he's known to us for other matters.
So, what's likely to happen now to me?
Oh, it doesn't look likely we'll be laying any charges at this stage.
Thank God.
Depends what this witness has got to say when we find him. You didn't see anyone in the vicinity?
Not that I can remember.
Well, the other...